Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk a little bit more about midlines. And I have a few other midline videos if you want to watch them, specifically more about how to get your midlines on in a braces case or an Invisalign case. We're not going to talk about that right now. We're just going to talk about the difference between facial midlines and dental midlines. So if you want to watch those other videos, you're going to want to go into my YouTube channel, which is Straight Smile Solutions YouTube channel, not your YouTube homepage in general. You go into the search bar at the top of your YouTube page, put in Straight Smile Solutions, and it'll bring up my channel. Then once you're in my channel, you go to that little tiny magnifying glass, top right, not corner, but just top right, about a quarter of the way down the page towards the right, and you put in midlines. And from there, you'll see all my videos on midlines and how to get them. Specifically today, we're going to talk about dental versus facial midlines. And when I work with my clients, my general and pediatric dentist and my prosthodontist, and even my orthodontist who work with me in my consulting practice, Straight Smile Solutions, often this comes up where they're struggling about the midlines. And I like to always clarify, which midline are you talking about? Are you talking about the dental midline, AKA, for example, this, or this, or are you talking about the facial midline, which is the midline with the face? Two different things, okay? And sometimes we can't have it all in orthodontics. We just can't. And remember, not all patients are symmetric. I'm certainly not symmetric. I can tell you I'm not. My nose is a little deviated. One side of my face is a little asymmetric. You guys can look at the videos. It's very obvious to me. Sorry, we're not all born totally symmetrical and even. So if we're not all born symmetrical and even, you know, that's just the way we were made, then we're not going to be symmetric with the midlines. That's just how it is. So ultimately, that's the first thing. I'm not even going to blow something up that's not a big deal, because 99.99% of the time, the patient has no idea what a facial midline is. They may know what a dental midline is, but they're probably not even going to notice if the midline is slightly off with the face. And I don't even think you should even stress about it unless it was part of the chief complaint. If it was part of the chief complaint, you may or may not even be able to get that on, because if they have some asymmetry, there's nothing you can do. So don't stress about it. Don't make a mountain out of a molehill. It's probably not a big deal. Let's try to get the bite looking good, fitting together well. Let's try to get that dental midline on the best we can, you know, the way it's meant to go. Remember, moving teeth is like a puzzle. And if we don't have complete symmetry, either in the shape and the size of the teeth or the face, it's not all gonna fit together perfectly. That's okay. That's why we have restorative. That's why we have IPR and other things like that. So for example, you can see here in this picture, this patient's dental midlines are pretty much coincident with her facial midlines. I drew a line from in between her eyes, going down to the tip of her nose, her philtrum, and down to her chin point. It's all pretty much lined up. Lucky for her. So is this patient. This patient is not, okay? This would be the facial midline. This would be the dental midline. It isn't coincident. Sorry, that's just how it is. Maybe he has an interference, and maybe he's sliding or pivoting over, okay? So I just wanted to create some awareness, just so when you're using the word midline in conversation, you're clarifying. I'm assuming most of the time when people say the word midline, they mean dental midline and not facial midline. But sometimes it doesn't happen. So anyways, just wanted to clarify that. All right, thanks so much. And you know what? If it looks like it's gonna be way off and it is part of the chief complaint, you wanna make sure you're not taking this case. This case needs to go to an orthodontist because it may need surgery, okay? Sometimes you can't just do these things with Invisalign or braces alone. Sometimes it involves a jaw surgery, so it may not be possible to give your patient everything. So if you have one of those hyper-obsessive patients that's asking for the world and you're a little confused, do not take that patient. Send it to an orthodontist. All right, thanks so much.